feet wrapped with strips of linen and a cloth around his face. Jesus said to them, "Take off the grave clothes and let him go." Therefore, many of the Jews who had come to visit Mary and had seen what Jesus did put their faith in him. But some of them went to the Pharisees and told them what Jesus had done. Then the chief priests and the Pharisees called a meeting of the Sanhedrin.
"What are we accomplishing?" they asked. "Here is this man performing many miraculous signs. Let him go on like this, and everyone will believe in him. Then the Roman
the Jews said,
"See how he loved him."
But some of them said,
"Could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying?"
Jesus, once more deeply moved, came to the tomb. It was a cave with a stone laid across the entrance. "Take away the stone," he said.
"My Lord,"
said one, "this is perfect."
"Here is this man performing many miraculous signs.
We let him go on like this, everyone will believe in him. Then the Romans will come and take away both our place and our nation."
Then one of them, named Caiaphas, who was the high priest that year, spoke up.
"You know nothing at all. You do not realize that it is better for you that one man die for the people than that the whole nation perish."
He did not say this on his own. But as high priest that year, he prophesied that Jesus would die for the Jewish nation. And not only for that nation, but also for the scattered children of God, to bring them together and make them one. So from that day on, they plotted to take his life. Therefore, Jesus no longer moved about publicly among the Jews. Instead, he withdrew to a region near the desert, to a village called Ephraim, where he stayed with his disciples. It was almost time for the Jewish Passover. Many went up from the country to Jerusalem for their ceremonial cleansing before the Passover. They kept looking for Jesus, and as they stood in the temple area, they asked one another,
"What do you think? Isn't he coming to the feast at all?"
But the chief priests and Pharisees had given orders that if anyone found out where Jesus was, he should report it so that they might arrest him. Chapter 11.
Jesus
said, "This sickness will not end in death."
No.
still at the place where Martha had met him. When the Jews who had been with Mary in the house, comforting her, noticed how quickly she got up and went out, they followed her, supposing she was going to the tomb to mourn there. When Mary reached the place where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet and said,
Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died.
When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who had come along with her also weeping, he was deeply moved in spirit.